Now, Professor Pramod Khadilkar.
Good morning, all. So I'm going to talk about making Chulha for BoP. And it comes with a disclaimer that case study in this presentation is anecdotal, because I feel that that's what happens in case of BoP and these kind of works, that anecdotes are taken for granted and a lot of conclusions are drawn based on that. So the work has been done at CPDM CST, which is formerly called as Astra, then using the help of Education Park, PS University, and a startup called as Rural Caravan. I don't want to spend a lot of time on telling you what is BOP. BOP is a population living below some threshold. They are generally identified with poverty. They face undesirabilities like lack of necessities, nutrition, healthcare, education. And I feel that we don't understand poverty that well. I'm mainly talking about designers. When Moroccan Farmal says that television is more important than food, it hits us back who are thinking that, okay, whatever we offer, if it is linked with his livelihood or its health, he's readily going to take it. Non-BOP manufacturers, designers' rationality is irrational for BOP many times. However, humans are not as rational as we think. So that is, anyway, it is there. Predicting desired situations for BOP is not straightforward. BOP as a market is informal, difficult to reach, lack of data, unpredictability. And at the same time, it is agile, flexible, it's very innovative, high at humane skills. So my work was on design methodology for BOP. So current design prevalent practices are product technology centric. Majority of products at BOP fail in positively affecting the targeted population. There is a lot of data available for this due to, and it can be measured in terms of lack of volumes, scalability, or lack of sustenance. Some of the products do impact, but they don't sustain long. Prevalent design with all the human-centered design methods has insufficient product-centric scope. And I mean it. There is a lot of data about, there is a lot of tool sets given by IDEO, and I feel that many of the times human-centered designs are used to ethicize what designer already wanted to say. They just use the tools and still come up with the same conclusions. So what design for BOP needs from my PhD work and my experience in field? I worked almost for 1 year in field. Out of that 4 to 5 months, I stayed in field. So I feel that if you take that central blue box as the current product-centric design scope, what we need for BOP is a pre-design scope, which is ends. What is the end of a product? Not a product itself, but the what it is offering to the users, ends as desired situations, additional supports like sub-products, processes, and services, context specificity, additional stakeholders related to non-technical aspects of product. And many of the presentations are linked with this, and it was quite supportive to what I'm trying to talk. Successful achievements of and post-design requirements are successful achievement of desired ends, engagement in post-dissemination phases. Design should not end at design of the technical product, but he should get involved till it stabilizes in the market. Readiness to redesign or troubleshoot product and or related supports. I'm going to talk about biomass cook stove, and I highlighted in the first slide its making, and I'm feeling proud saying that I was involved only in making of cook stoves, not design of cook stoves, and I don't feel any bad about it. Biomass cook stoves, there is large demand. There's a lot of data available on this. I don't want to go through all this. I'm talking about cook stove design at Astra, designed by Professor Kumar and late Professor Lokras. So it has three heat extraction points. One is for where directly flame is received, jawar, roti, rice can be made. Sambar or dal can be made at the second heat extraction point, and the third heat extraction point has water heating. And it has very good efficiency of 40%, complete removal of indoor smoke using chimney, and consistently saves more than 50% firewood. More than 1.5 million stoves are disseminated till now. So and it is very scientifically designed. It's, though it looks made in mud and clay, there's a lot of science which has gone behind this. So original method of manufacturing was the stove is made in situ in the house of the person who needs it. Initially it started brick and mortar, and it depended on the mason skill, because if you see in this, there is a lot of variation in the dimension, and those dimensions are quite crucial. And the what we started with in my PhD is rammed earth technology using mold. So rammed earth technology is pioneered by Professor B.B.V. Reddy in civil department, as well as Astra or CST, and Mr. H.I. Somshekhar. He first gave me the idea that, okay, we can make this mold. And I came up with this mold. This is a small video. So quite elaborate. So there is a mold inside which a sand soil mixture of very specific amount is placed, and then the mold gets dismantled using certain steps, and very precise geometry is made using all this mold. Very fancy collapsible walls which you can use and then remove using. There is no fastener which is used which is not available in the market. In everything and each thing, there is nothing which is required specifically to be made for this other than the carpentry work. So this is the mold. Cost is something around 8,000 rupees. It is definitely more now because this is some 5 years back estimate. It can make 152 to 250 stoves definitely. I have tested this in market. Cost per stove using 150 stoves is 54 per stove. And enclosing volume is 140 centimeter by 40 centimeter by 33 centimeter. So if you see that this is how, if these many parts are there in this, and these are the details. And if you see that a lot of thoughts has been gone into this, if you see this part is dismantleable, mainly because inside the house you need different chimney locations. So if you want to shift the chimney location, you can just lift that part, rotate, and the chimney location can be shifted. At the same time, the ash pit can be used from the other side, so you can put it to any wall. So all those factors are there. And these are the top plates which are required to be made separately using these molds. And I feel that this is a successful failure. Okay, so I'll take 2 minutes, sorry for that. And yesterday we were talking about curriculums designed for design students. Are we giving them S grades for successful failures? And according to me, this was successful failure, because when I went to mark in the field, I realized that they shift this mold using two-wheelers. When we were there, there are big vans available for us, cars available, they'll put everything in car, they take it to the villages. But when everyone left, they were left with a two-wheeler to transfer this mold. And it was not possible to make the mold stoves using this. So, but still, the old mold was quite successful. 300 stoves were sold, not a single government-funded stove, and still it is going on. There is a person who is doing this independently right now. It is run with a NGO called as EduPark. And then I said that I was technology-centric, just shared this whole thing, and I came up with this mold for the same work. It has only two parts. It costs around 2,000 rupees. It doesn't need a top plate mold. It can make same 150 to 250 stoves, 13 rupees per stove, and it reduces the making time immensely. So what I have done essentially is the wall, which was designed in the mold, I said the bricks are available everywhere. Can they just borrow some bricks? None of these bricks are used for the final stove, so it doesn't cost them anything. So once they can use anything for the outer boundary, only the inner core is a part of mold now. And the top plate, which was made earlier separately and carried by the people, now it is made on the stove. So this top plate mold is made in such a way that it is just kept there. You fill the mixture around and it is done. Yeah, so this, and now I'm scrapping this also, because I'm thinking that there is inflatable mold, there is something which is coming up, and one time 40 rupees mold, that is something I'm working with Rural Caravan right now as an extension of this. And the model is, we can sell stoves at petty shops in each village. So you'd be able to go to a petty shop and say that I want a stove, and they'll give you something with which you'll just make a stove, and it'll work as efficiently as Astra stove. And bottlenecks are chimney pipes still, and we are working on that. So thank you.